Just very good morning to all of you and welcome to the lecture series on virtual labs of electrical machines. And in today's lecture, I am going to cover how we can run this virtual platform for experiment, or you can do the simulations or the exercises in Ubuntu operating system. So in the virtual labs, we need to install the virtual lab box, and in the virtual lab box, we need to install the Ubuntu operating system, and the whole the virtual labs of this IITs will work on the Ubuntu operating system. So for this, we need to go to the virtual lab site. So this is the virtual lab website. You need to go this, and in the bottom side there is one announcement tab. We need to click on this tab also. On this tab, there is one documentation where we can find how we can install the virtual lab box and how we can install the virtual lab box Ubuntu operating system in the virtual lab box. So scroll down, you will get this is the link to download the virtual lab box. So click on this link and it is being downloaded. So click on this Windows host and then you will get this software. I have already downloaded this and installed this, so I need not to go to the same again. So you will do like this. Similarly, you need to download the one more file, or you can say image, and then down. This is point number 5. We need to click on this link. It is the Ubuntu image, and here there is a 3.09 GB image is available. You need to just click on this and download. So you need to download two software here. The first is the virtual lab box, the second is this image file of the Ubuntu virtual lab box. So I have already downloaded all these softwares and I have already installed this. So just you need to click on this and you can install this virtual lab box. After installing this, there is one icon which will be displayed in your screen. This is Oracle VM Virtual Lab Box. So click on this icon. You need to import this Ubuntu image in this Virtual Lab Box manager. So click on import. Here I am going to click on this. I have downloaded this system Ubuntu. So just click on this and press it is enter. Then press enter. Then after few minutes it will stop. So it will take around 1 to 2 minutes to install this Ubuntu image in the Virtual Lab Box. So we need to wait for 2 minutes here. Now it is almost going to finish. So here we can see in the virtual lab box manager, we have the Ubuntu image is uploaded here, and then we need to go to some settings, and if you want to increase some speed of this processor, you need to make it to, let's suppose I'm using this 4. If you have any 4, then you can go use 2, or you can set some more a setting as per your need. So at this time, don't disturb this, and I just click on the start button here. So after clicking on the start button, the Ubuntu operating system will start. It will take 1 to 2 minutes to get started. So here you can see there is this OS, Ubuntu OS is going to be started. So this is the Ubuntu OS. So I just click on this view and click on the full screen mode. So I need one password here. So I just go back to this screen mode. I just go to the Windows, and in Windows there is one password is available here, which is saying here it is down. There is a CC. So CC is the password for this. So I just click on this, then show, and then type the password CC here, then press enter. So here we are. Our Ubuntu operating virtual machine is installed in the system. It is installed in the Windows 10, and now we are working on this Linux system. So just to start the virtual machine, you need to click on this Mozilla Firefox here and type Google on this. After that, you need to type virtual labs. Virtual labs, then click on this www.vlab.co.in here, and scroll down, I need to open the electrical machines lab, so I need to go to the electrical engineering, and here I need to scroll down, and I just want to open this IIT Guwahati electrical machines lab, so I click on this. Let's suppose I want to open this short circuit test or any test, so I just go to this experiment. And every time when we click on this, they will ask him about to activate the flash player, so just allow now. And here we can get our simulation panel, and by using some precaution, a procedure is there, we can connect the wires and do our experimentation. So this is the basic thing that I want to share with you, how we can run the all the simulations or the experiments in this Ubuntu operating system. When we're talking about the Windows, if you want to do the same thing in the Windows, let's suppose in the Windows I am going towards this electrical engineering laboratory, or we can say the IIT Guwahati lab. I am just click on this block rotor test and I want to open this experiment, so there will be some issue. There is an ad hoc flash player is no longer supported. That means since December 2020, Google stopped, or you can say block, this Adobe flash player, and most of the labs of this virtual lab is working on this Adobe flash player. So in Windows it becomes very difficult, or I think it may not be possible to open the virtual lab. Some of the labs may be open, but those who are depend upon the Adobe flash player, it will not work. For that you need to go to this virtual machine, and you need to go to the Ubuntu OS, and we need to connect the wires and do the simulation. That's all. So this is the end of this lecture, and in the next lecture we will do some more exercises on the machines. So thank you very much. Take care of yourself and so on.